एक्सरसाइज 14.1 इज अ एक्सरसाइज फॉर यू, मतलब सम एक्टिविटी. सो दैट एक्टिविटी इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड यू कैन डू इट. बॉर्ड पीपल आर नॉट गोइंग टू आस्क टू डू दैट. ओके, वी स्टार्ट विथ एक्सरसाइज 14.2 बेस्ड ऑन ग्रुप फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड अनग्रुप फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, हाउ टू फॉर्म. ओके, फर्स्ट सम इज द ब्लड ग्रुप ऑफ 30 स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास क्लास 8 आर रिकॉर्डेड एज फॉलोज. सी सम, देयर आर फोर टाइप ऑफ ब्लड ग्रुप ए बी ओ एंड ए बी. रिप्रेजेंट दिस डेटा इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन टेबल, मतलब अनग्रुप. What is the most common and which is a rarest blood group among the student? This answer of this question can be, you can find it very easily from a table which you are going to form. So here, first we write here the blood group. There are four types of blood group. So I just write blood group A, blood group B, blood group O and blood group AB. Four type of blood group. Now I put here tally mark. And then I write here frequency, number of students. Matlab frequency, okay. Now see, if I put a tally, first I will take A. So I put tally mark against A and put cross at A. Then I take B. I put cross at B and put tally mark against B. This way also you can continue up to till you get at point O. Or otherwise you count how many students are having blood group A. अगर आप पूरे डेटा में से काउंट करोगे तो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 9 students are having blood group A. So directly you can form 9 tally mark against A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2, 3, 4. So 9 students are having blood group A. Then if you count for B, B mein aapko milegi 6 bachche. 6 students are having blood group B. So 6 is a frequency of blood group B. Then ओ ओके लिए आपको गिनोगे तो 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2. सो 12 स्टूडेंट्स आर हैविंग ब्लड ग्रुप ओ. एंड ए बी में यू विल फाइंड ओनली 3 स्टूडेंट्स आर हैविंग ब्लड ग्रुप ए बी. सो मोस्ट कॉमन ब्लड ग्रुप इज व्हाट? ओ. व्हाई? बिकॉज ओ इज हाईएस्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी. ब्लड ग्रुप ओ हैज अ हाईएस्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो मोस्ट कॉमन ब्लड ग्रुप. कुछ आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ओ, बिकॉज ओ इज अ ओ हैज अ बिकॉज ओ हैज अ हाईएस्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी. व्हाई दैट मोस्ट कॉमन ब्लड ग्रुप इज ए? बिकॉज ओ हैज हाईएस्ट फ्रीक्वेंसी. ओके, नाउ which blood group is very rare? So rarest blood group is a blood group with lowest frequency. So rarest blood group among student is AB. Among student is equal to AB. Why? Because AB has lowest frequency. Okay, from raw data you can't make this decision very fast, you can't get answer of this question very fast, but when you present them, right, when you represent them into groups, then answer of such questions are at a glance very easily you can find out. Okay, so this is the benefit of frequency distribution. Okay, second sum is the distance in kilometer of 40 engineers from their residence to their place of work were found as follows. Data is given. construct a group frequency, here we have to make group frequency distribution with class size 5. For the data given above, taking the first interval is 0 to 5, so second will be 5 to 10. 5 is not included in 0 to 5. 5 to 10 may, 5 is included but 10 is not included. What main features do you observe from the tabular representation? After getting tabular representation, you are asked to say something about the data. What do you observe? Right? So, तो हम टेबल बनाने के बाद डिसाइड करेंगे. Okay? Now see, you form the first of all table. I will write, क्या करूंगी मैं? Distance in kilometer, okay? Better I should write down. अच्छा चलेगा. Distance in kilometer. Here is telemark. मैंने telemark कैसे करने का वो तो बता दिया ना आपको. N frequency. सीधा गिनो या एक एक करके क्रॉस करके एक एक telemark against each class रखो. Okay? It is up to you. 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, 20 to 25, 25 to 30, and 30 to 35. This is the last class. Now, telemark karna hai, to pehle kya karenge? 5. I put cross at 5 and put telemark against 5 to 10. Clear? 5 to 10 ke samne telemark aayegi, barabar? 5 to 10 ke samne. Fir 3, to 3 upar aayega. Fir 10, to 10 aayega tisre class mein, okay? Fir 20, 20 aayega 5ve class ke samne. Okay, like that. That way you continue. Last mein, last observation kar doge, baad mein aayega tumhara total telemark. 0 to 5 mein aapko 5 tally aayegi, 5. 5 to 10 में आपको 11 टेली मिलेगी, 11. 5, 5 के दो ग्रुप एंड एक एक्स्ट्रा. थर्ड क्लास में 10 to 15 में भी 11 ही आएगी टेली मार्क. ओके, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 और 1. फिर 15 to 20 में आपके पास 9 टेली मार्क आएगी. 9 observation are between this 15 to 20. Okay? Then 20 to 25 में एक ही telemark आएगी. 20 to 25 में. 25 to 30 में भी एक ही आएगी. और 30 to 35 में दो आएगी. So my frequencies are पहले class की 5, दूसरे की 11, तीसरे की 11, चौथे की 9, 1, 1 and 2 and my total will be coming 40. Now see here, maximum engineers are, देखो, 5 plus 11. 5 plus 11 plus 11 plus 9, that is 36. And 1 plus 1 plus 2, matlab 4. From this data, what do you observe? Most of the engineering are living nearby. Between the maximum number of engineers live within 0 to 20 kilometer distance. Very few stay far away from their place of work. And that is only 4. So, what do you observe from this table? The observation is the maximum numbers of engineers live within 0 to 20 kilometer distances. Okay? Very few stay far away. far away from place of work. Now third sum, you try by your own a relative humidity in percentage of a certain city for a month of 30 days was as follows. And you are asked three questions. Construct a group frequency distribution table with classes 84 to 86 and 86 to 88, etc., etc. Which month or season do you think this data is about and what is the range of the data? Here class length is 2. And range is maximum minus minimum. Minus minimum observation. What is maximum observation? 99.2. And minimum is 84.9. So my range is 14.3. Now range upon class length is number of class, okay? Range upon class length is equal to number of classes. Here my range is 14.3 and class length is 2. So my approximately my number of class are 7.01. Matlab approximately 8. There are 8 classes. Here also upper limit is not included and lower limit is included. So now I am forming the table. Relative humidity. Humidity. Here is a tally mark. And here is a frequency. Okay. पहले टेबल बना देते हैं, बाद में वी आर आंसरिंग देयर क्वेश्चंस. क्लासेस आर 84 टू 86, 86 टू 88, 88 टू 90, 90 टू 92, 92 टू 94, 94 टू 96, 96 टू 98. And 98 to 100, because maximum should be included. Okay, tally mark में आप करते जाओ 84 to less than 86, 84 and less than 86. How many? One observation is there. Then इसके लिए भी one observation you will get. Then you will get two observation against 88 to 90. Then two observation against 90 to 92. Then 5 and 2, 7 observation against 92 to 94. Then 6 observation against 94 to 96. 96 to 98, 7 observation. 5 and 2, 7. And 98 to 100, there are only 4 observation. If you applied the process of cancelling the entry and putting tally mark against each class, you are going to get number of tally marks like this. So my frequency is (1, 1, 2, 2, 7, 6, 7, and 4). And if you make the total of all the frequency, it is coming 30. So your table is perfectly right. Now see, here upper limit is not included. If 84 to 86, then 86 is not included. In most of the day, humidity is high. Dekho. In most of the day, humidity is high. Kyunki 84 to 86 1 and 86 to 88 1 and 88 to 90 only 2 and 90 to 92 2 frequency. Most of the days 7 plus 6 plus 7 plus 4, out of 30 days 24 days humidity is high. So first question comes, pehla construct a group frequency distribution table, wo to ho gaya. Second question ka, which month or season do you think this data is about? So most of the days, in most of the day humidity is high. So it must be a month of rainy season, okay? Second ka answer, in most of the day, humidity is high. Is high. Therefore, this season must be a rainy season. Season must be a, क्योंकि rainy season में humidity high होती है. Be a rainy season. And third question is about what is the range? And range we calculated, it is 14.3. So third का answer, range is 14.3 and table तो हमने बना दिया. So are you getting same answer? Now sum number 4. The height of 50 students measured to nearest centimeter have been found to be as follows. Represent the data given by a group frequency distribution table taking the class interval 160 to 165, 165 to 170, etc. etc. And second is, what can you conclude about their height from table? So two questions they have asked. So first I have to form the group frequency table, okay? So I write here height in centimeter, then telemark, and then frequency. Height is, I am starting from 150 to 155, then 155 to 160, 160 to 165, 165 to 170. And 170 to 175. Why I stop at 175? Because my maximum height is given is 172. Okay? Because range is here maximum observation minus minimum observation. My maximum is 172 and minimum is 151. So my range is here 172 minus 151. So, it's a, how much? 2 minus 1, 1 and 7 minus 21. So, 21 divided by 5. So, round about 5 tables, 5 classes should be constructed. And highest, upper limit of the last class is 175. Because 172 is included between 170 to 175. Clear? Now I will put telemark. जैसे मैंने बताया है, एक observation ले लो 161 observation ले लो, put cross on it and put telemark again 162 165. Okay? Then put cross on 150. And put telemark against first class 150 to 155. Then 154 put cross and 154 matlab you should put telemark in front of first class 150 to 155 like that. You reach up to, you start from 161 and reach up to 159. After completing your process of telemark, you observe that first class 150 to 155, there are 12 telemarks. How many? 12 telemark, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 2. So frequency is 12, okay? Then 150 to 155 to 160. Number of telemark are 9. So a group of 5 and 4 more. So it is frequency is 9. Third class 160 to 165. You see telemark are, total number of telemark are 14. Two groups of 5 and one group of 4. Okay, so 14. Then 165 to 170. Total are 10. So, two groups of 5. And 170 to 175, 5. If you make the total of all the frequency, sigma fi इसको बोलते हैं, you will be getting 50, मतलब your table is perfectly right. Now, table तो हो गया. Second question, what can you conclude about their heights from table? Conclusion is, see from table, what do you conclude? One conclusion, that we can draw from above table. One conclusion that can be drawn, that we can draw from above table is that more than 50% of students are shorter than 165 centimeter. Okay, 165 से भी कम height वाले कितने हैं? More than 50%. देखो, 12 plus 9 plus 14. So, कितने हुए? 26 and 9, 35. Out of 50, 35 are having height less than 165. Clear? Now, sum number 5 of 14.2. A study was conducted to find out the concentration of sulfur dioxide in the air in part per million, मतलब ppm, of a certain city. The data obtained for 30 days are as follows. Data is given, see, it is in a decimal. First question is, make a group frequency distribution table for this data with class interval 0.00 to 0.04, then 0.04 to 0.08, मतलब class length is 0.04. And we start from 0.00 to 0.04 and we are reaches up to 0.20 to 0.24. Because maximum concentration of sulfur dioxide, maximum in air is, आप देखो maximum कितना है, देखो, less than 0.24. Maximum आप देखो, मुझे 0.24 तक जाना पड़ेगा. क्योंकि मैक्सिमम देखो, मैक्सिमम 0.20 से ज्यादा है. सो लास्ट क्लास इज 0.20 टू 0.24. फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज वाज द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड मोर देन 0.11 पार्ट्स पर मिलियन पर 8 मिलियन, दैट सेकंड क्वेश्चन, नहीं पर मिलियन. इफ यू, सो टू क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज टू फॉर्म अ टेबल एंड सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज you have to answer how many days was the concentration of sulfur dioxide is more than 0.11. More than 0.11 मतलब 0.12 से शुरू करके 0.24 तक जाना पड़ेगा. Okay, now first of all I form a table. Concentration of sulfur dioxide. Second is telemark and third is frequency. First class is 0.00 to 0.04. Second is 0.04 to 0.08. Then 0.08 to 0.12. 0.12 to 0.16. 0.16 to 0.20 and 0.20 to 0.24. Telemark कैसे करना मैंने बता दिया है. Put cross, right, and here the total table is given. तो उसमें से telemark आप डेटा में से ले लो. सी डेटा में आपको डेटा दिया है ना, एक एक डेटा ले लो, 0.03 पुट क्रॉस पुट टैली अगेंस्ट दी क्लास, देन 0.08 पुट क्रॉस टेक टैली मार्क अगेंस्ट दी क्लास. दिस वे यू कंटिन्यू दी प्रोसेस ऑफ टैली मार्किंग. यू ऑब्जर्व दैट बिटवीन 0.00 टू लेस देन 0.4 हाउ मेनी ऑब्जर्वेशन, मतलब टैली मार्क टोटल नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन आर 4. सो फ्रीक्वेंसी फॉर दैट नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन अगेंस्ट 0.00 टू 0.04 इज 4, देन 0.04 टू 0.8 9 टैली, 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4, देन 0.08 इंक्लूडिंग एंड लेस देन 0.12 मतलब अप टू 0.11 तक देर विल बी 9 टैली, 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 सो 9. देन 0.12 टू 0.16 ओनली 2 ऑब्जर्वेशन, अप टू नहीं लेस देन 0.16, देन 0.16 टू लेस देन 0.20 देर आर 4, एंड 0.20 टू लेस देन 0.24 इज देर आर 2, एंड टोटल ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी यू आर गेटिंग सिग्मा एफ आई, सिग्मा मतलब टोटल ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी इज 30. सो माई टेबल इज परफेक्टली राइट. नाउ क्वेश्चन, इफ यू काउंट फ्रॉम द टेबल द नंबर ऑफ डेज कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज लेस देन 0.04 आर 4, सो पुट 4 टैली मार्क अगेंस्ट क्लास 0.00 टू 0.04, देन 9 टैली आर बिटवीन 0.04 टू 0.08. नाउ इफ यू सी फ्रॉम द टेबल, the concentration of sulfur dioxide was more than 0.11, more than 0.11 मतलब 0.12 से शुरू करके 0.24 तक, right? तो 0.12 से शुरू करके तो 2 + 4 + 2 = 8. So the concentration, second question का answer, the concentration ऑफ सल्फर इज मोर देन 0.11, मोर देन 0.11 मतलब स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 0.12 ppm फॉर 8 days. The concentration of sulfur is more than 0.8 ppm for 8 days. Okay, that's the answer of this question. So, we can get the answer very easily from table. Okay, raw data mein wo answer itna easily nahi milega jitna group data mein se milega. Okay, now 6 sum, 3 coins were tossed 30 times simultaneously. Each time, the number of heads occurring was noted. Draw down as follows. Prepare a frequency distribution table for the data given below. बराबर, अभी पहले क्या निकालेंगे हम, मैक्सिमम ऑब्जर्वेशन कितना दिया है 3, मिनिमम ऑब्जर्वेशन कितना दिया है 0. सो इट इज अ डिस्क्रीट, मिनिमम टू मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन आर वेरी लेस, डेटा इज वेरी शॉर्ट. So here we form खाली frequency table, not group. We form discrete frequency table, okay? Discrete frequency table. We start from minimum and reaches up to maximum, okay? So here I write number of heads. Number of heads starts with minimum 0 and reaches up to 3, because 3 times we toss, so number of heads cannot be more than 3. Tally mark karo and frequency karo, do hi to cheez bola hai, table hi banana hai. See, you see 0 occurs 6 times, count karo, 0 occur 1 2 3 4 5 6, so 0 occurs 6 times. So tally mark again 0 are six. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now 1 occur 10 times. So 10 tally mark. 2 occur 9 times. 5 ka group or 4 ka group. And 3 occur 5 times. 30 you are getting 30. So my table is perfectly right. Okay. 7 is similar to 6. Right. It is also discrete frequency table. And the value of pi up to 50 decimal places is given below. Okay. 3.141592653585879323846264333 and so on. Make a frequency distribution of the digit from 0 to 9 after the decimal point. Matlab 3 ko nahi ginne ka. 3 ke baad, 3 point ke baad, how many times 0 occur, how many times 1 occur and how many times 9 occur. What are the most and the least frequency occurring digits? Very simple. I write here digits, okay, then tally mark, and then frequency. First we write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, है ना? तो 0 वाले कितने हैं? 2 time, दो ही tally mark, so 2 time. फिर 1 occur how many times? 5 times. 2 occur 5 times, 3 occur 8 times, 4 occur 4 times, 5 occur 5 times, 6 occur 4 times, 7 occur 4 times, 8 occur 5 times, and 9 occur 8 times. Total आ गया 50. Similar है तो tally mark आप करेंगे. Now, what is a digit having highest frequency? Digit 3 is having highest frequency for 8. So, digit 3 occur digit 3 occurs 3 times because 3 frequency of 3 is 8 and which digit occur lowest? 0 has lowest frequency. 0 has lowest frequency. Clear? 0 digit has a lowest frequency 2 and 3 has a highest frequency 8. Clear? So it's very similar to sum number 5. So you can do by your own. Okay? 8. 13 children were asked about the number of hours they watched TV program in the previous week. The result were found as follows. Make a group frequency distribution table for this data taking class width 5 and one of the class is 5 to 10. How many children watch TV for 15 or more hours in a week? Very simple. Hum kya karenge idhar? Banayenge number of hours, tally mark, and frequency. Number of hours we are writing in an interval. My first interval is 0 to 5 as they said, then 5 to 10, then 10 to 15, and 15 to 20. Clear? 15 to 20. Maximum is between 15 to 20. Minimum is 1 and maximum is 17. What is? Minimum observation is 1 and maximum observation is 17. So 70 is included in interval 15 to 20. Okay. Now, tally mark aap karoge, to 0 to 5. 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. 5 is not included. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, how many times they occur? 10 times. Okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 10, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 occur. How many times? 10 times. Altogether, 5 to 10 mein 13 observations are there. 5, 5 and 3. So 13 is a frequency of interval 5 to 10. 10 to 15 mein 5 hi observation aaye. And 15 to 20 mein khali 2 telemark aayi. Total is coming 30. So only 2 children watch TV 15 or more than 15 hours. Okay. Baki sab bachche to 14 hours, less than 15 hours TV dekhte hain. Okay. Very simple. Clear? A company manufactures car batteries of a particular type of lives and years of 40 such batteries were recorded as follows. Construct a group frequency distribution table for this data using class interval of size 0.5, starting from 2 to 2.5, then 2.5 to 3. You have to put telemark in. So, I am writing direct answer. You can do by your own. Okay, this sum. देखो मैं बताती हूँ टेबल ही बनाना है और कोई सवाल तो पूछा नहीं वो लोगों ने तो हम लिखेंगे लाइफ ऑफ बैटरीज इन ईयर्स एंड टैली मार्क आप करेंगे मैं फ्रीक्वेंसी बता देती हूँ एन फ्रीक्वेंसी इंटरवल आर 2.5 to 3, 3 to 3.5, 3.5 to 4, 4.4 to 4.5 and 4.5 to 5 because maximum are between 4.5 to 5 and frequency आएगी तुम्हारी मैं लिख के देती हूँ 2, 6, 14, 11, 4 and 3 total आएगा 40 and that complete your exercise 14.2 clear this is a representation of data in a form of discrete frequency table and group frequency table मतलब continuous frequency table now we are going to learn how to represent data graphically representation of data graphically representation of data graphically now see it is a better way to represent It is a better way to represent data. Graphical way is a better way to represent the data. As we know that one picture is better than 1000 words. By means of graph, we can compare the individual item. The following are the graphs. We are going to learn the following graphs. Are the graphs. In our syllabus. First is bar graphs. It is for discrete frequency table. Okay. Second is histogram. Histogram mein do type ke hain. Of uniform width. Class length are same. Or second histogram we can draw varying width. And third is a frequency polygon. Three graphs you are going to learn. One, this graph, first graph for discrete frequency and this second and third for continuous frequency distribution. Okay. Now what is bar chart? What is bar chart? As I said, bar chart is for discrete table or only simple frequency distribution table. A bar graph is a pictorial representation. A bar graph is a pictorial representation of data in which usually bars of uniform width. Width of each bar should be same. Bars of uniform width are drawn with equal spacing between two bars. Equal spacing between two bars. दो बार्स के बीच में स्पेसिंग सेम होने चाहिए एंड विड्थ इज ऑल्सो शुड बी सेम इक्वल स्पेसिंग बिटवीन देम इक्वल स्पेसिंग बिटवीन टू बार्स ऑन एक्स एक्सिस रिप्रेजेंटिंग वेरिएबल And the values of variable, the value of variable are represented on another axis that is called y-axis. The height of bars represent the values of the variable. The height, width is constant. The height of bars depend on the values of the variable. Okay.